What's kale? Is it like beef jerky?
In the end, it turned out they were actually the same person.
Secret Window?
What?
Are you guys talking about the 2004 suspense thriller, Secret Window?
We're talking about my dad's dissociative identity disorder. But thanks for ruining Secret Window, weirdo.
I'm just messing with you. Relax.
Yeah.
First off, I'd like to thank you all for being part of today's focus group. My name is Alfred Winstanley, and in front of you are serving bowls of our company's latest concoction. Please, enjoy.
Mmm, salty.
Tastes like the body of Christ at a local church.
Reminds me of the rations we ate in the cut.
Yeah, that unmistakable rush of stabbing a man in the throat with a bayonet.
What if I told you that you were eating none other than the new and improved saltines from Royal Crackers Incorporated?
Wait, is this the Royal Crackers building? Is that why we were blindfolded after being abducted? Take us back to the DMV this instant!
Weren't they single-handedly responsible for the statewide polio outbreak?
Any man or child who falls to illness is dead weight. Kick him out of the foxhole and let the artillery sort him out, I say.
I'll never give a dollar to your company as long as Theodore Hornsby remains at the helm. He's a monster! And quite the eyesore.
He's not more than a sad old man stuck in the past. And a bigot.
Well, well, well. Where do I fucking shit. Where do I begin? Okay, you first. I'm an eyesore? Why, if I hadn't shattered that two-way mirror, I'd ask you to take a good look at yourself and explain how that crucifix had been burned through that Nosferatu-like body of yours.
Be gone, Satan.
You there. You think I'm stuck in the past? Unhip? I've rubbed elbows with the likes of Buford Stanley and the Spinners, Fred Gladys and the Brooklyn Berries, Donald Brindley and the Puerto Rican Seven. And then you have the nerve to call me a bigot? I'm sorry. Then why are there two Donald Brindley and the Puerto Rican Seven albums in my record collection? And you? You're right, actually. I like you. No notes. And you. If I had any idea what race you were, I'd be having a field day right now. Good day.
Finally, I'd like to dedicate the Hottest Woman Ever Award to my fellow nominees. Nikki, Emily, it's been an honor to be nominated alongside you.
Move it, Deb! I gotta take a fat piss!
Jesus! What is wrong with you?
Now that I got the Z-pad, I pee sitting down. Ugh, what are you wearing, dude? If you're gonna walk around in pajamas, put on a Snuggie. You look gross.
Oh, really? You might want to keep your headphones on tonight if you don't want to be kept awake by the rhythmic banging of Steve and I's headboard.
No can do. This baby came with a free trial of Z-music. I'm taking my dad through the entire Taint discography tonight. Got a long night ahead of us.
Showtime. Hope Steve's ready to lambaste me with some disgusting dirty talk.
Oh, hey, Deb. I'm watching a news piece about school censoring Huck Finn's aggressive use of the N-word.
Oh, hey. You like what you see?
Well, it's a hot-button issue, but Twain did say it was meant to challenge the reader.
The lingerie, Steve!
Oh, you know, actually, I'm not sure I'm up for that, Deb.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm just a little tired. Yeah, that's it. Tired. Will I ever be normal again?
Look at this fat tub of shit. Hey, it's okay. I can say it, because that tub of shit is me.
Hi, I'm Keith, founder of MyCycle, a new, fun, virtual meditative exercise that connects you with other riders supporting each other in obtaining that perfect body and achieving maximum zen. So, join me and my hand-picked group of elite riders as we personally lead you towards a spiritual awakening. See you there, Deb.
Welcome to Intimate Inmate, matching you sexy soon-to-be parolees with the most desperate, impressionable bachelors in town.
Hi, I'm Jim. I'm in the market for someone to have intercourse with. I don't ever have intercourse because most women are repulsed by the fact that I...
Doris! What did I tell you about watching dating profiles on my TV VCR combo unit?
Oh, sorry, Serenity. I'm getting up next week, so decided to start weighing my options.
Hi, I'm Bob. I'm looking for a chick that I can have financial superiority over.
Are you listening? Turn this off and put something on I enjoy.
Hi, I'm Darby. I'm a former criminal lawyer, and I love a good scallop. Due to a dark cloud of existential loneliness that worsens with every birthday, I've decided to give this dating thing a shot.
You pushed me too far, you selfish jerk!
So, what do you say? Are you the tide to push my lifeboat off this endless ocean of sadness?
Prince Omar, care to tell your parents about what happened at school today?
I don't like the sound of that.
He was protesting the curriculum his teacher provided.
Come with me, young man. Omar, one day the city of Bidai will be yours to rule.
You'll make a great leader one day, Omar. One who leads by example. That means respecting your superiors along the way.
Run along now. It'll be time for bed soon enough.
Oh, is that fine? Is that...
Welcome back to Rock Assault. I'm here with Taint frontman Theo Hornsby. Now, your new album, Drown Your Sibling, has come under fire because of its strong anti-parent, anti-authority lyrics.
MLK, Malcolm X, Tupac. What do they have in common? They're all exactly like me. You see, the establishment wants us silenced, but I got a little message for them. Sorry, but Taint's gonna dominate the radio waves till the end of time. When you're in Taint Nation, you're in for life. We ain't gonna stop for no one. Neither is radio or physical media.
Suck it down! Awesome, Theo.
Hey, you met our hype man, Moe D? Moe! Get over here!
Let's watch the video for the album's first single, Two in the Pink, One in the Stink.
Okay, time for bed, young man.
Mother? Father? Fuck you!
Everyone, can I have your attention, please? Ma'am? Ma'am, sir, stop. Stop talking, please. Thank you. Now, I know you're all looking at each other like, who is this jerk interrupting my chicken wings? Well, I'm Steve, and I want to make a toast to my beautiful wife, Deb, a.k.a. the lucky winner of today's KQAC Alternative Radio's call-in grand prize, a $100 gift card here at Chucklebee's.
And a free copy of The Matrix on DVD. So.
Anyway, don't let me interrupt.
Can everyone pause for a second? I have a speech to make. Let's quiet down now. Now you're probably all saying to each other, God, we just had to listen to a toast. Now we gotta listen to this hot piece of ass make another speech. I just wanted to say that after winning today's KQAC call-in prize, I just feel like the luckiest bitch in the-
Oh, yeah! Yeah.
Give me those sizzling fajitas, baby!
Yes!
You know what I love about this place? The food is
just like a mama used to make.
Hey, forget about it.
Oh, my God. If anyone hurt us right now, they'd put us in a mental institution.
Yeah, I'm crazy, too. Watch this.
Meth.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Well, there goes my f***ing appetite.
So sorry to interrupt. My son over there farted, and I just wanted to apologize for that.
Hi, I'm sorry. You guys might be smelling something kind of weird. My son farted.
Hey, ladies.
Just doing some damage control. Did you guys happen to hear or smell anything weird?
Let us pay for your jalapeno poppers, please.
1,000 apologies. 1,000 apologies.
Because if you did, it was probably definitely him. Right there. He farted.
So, Rachel, hearing a lot of buzz about your marketing presentation next week. I hear it may even be, dare I say, promotion-worthy, question mark?
Oh, it's really not that big a deal.
Under-promise, over-deliver.
I like your style, Rach.
Smart.
Just hearing about this presentation has given me some sick leakage. May I be excused? I should change into my shitty underwear before these are soaked.
Oh, really bummed I'm gonna miss it, Rach.
Is everything okay, guys?
Rachel, this is our very own, very expensive bottle of wine. My father had it sent to me on the day of my 8th grade graduation with this note. Drink this when life can't get any better. Well, Dad, it's time we finally say cheers.
Wow. Steve, that is so...
Don't touch it!
You lost your freaking mind, lady?
You think this is the day that my life couldn't get any better?
We're being bled dry, Rachel.
Got investors crawling up my ass.
That thing about my underwear was no disingenuous anecdote.
Day collectors calling day and night.
I'm down to 3 pairs.
We open that bottle after your presentation saves the company. Capiche?
Pressure's on.
Listen, Barry, we need to be featured more prominently on your shelves. We want Royal Crackers displayed on the end cap. That's right. I know what the end of the aisle's called now. End cap. Because someone just started watching Shark Tank. It's me. Learned a lot. No more BS and old Steve. What's that? Uh-huh. No, yeah, you're right. You're right. I know, look, I'm under a lot of pressure over here. I didn't mean to take it out on you. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry too, Barry.
Theo, what are you doing? I'm practicing my phone calls. That line could have been hot.
I'm tired of all this nonsense between us about who's top dog at this company. The tit for tat, the back and forth, the will they, won't they?
We need to say once and for all, who's in charge of Royal Crackers?
I'm in charge of the company. I do all the work because someone has to keep the train on the tracks around here.
You're right. You're so right. You're the boss.
Well, thank you for admitting that. Waited a long time to hear you say that.
I think we should make it official. Sign here and you're officially the one in charge.
You got it.
Well, look at you, top dog.
Hey, Theo.
You're a good brother.
I try.
You hear that, Barry? That's right. I'm the boss. Me, Steve Hornsby, a.k.a. Boss Man.
Yes, I see it too, Alfred. Yes, it's a fire at Factory 6. Well done.
No, I'll handle it. Connect me to the factory's head operator. Not in today. For why? Christmas? You mean this new holiday the bureaucrats at City Hall are forcing down our throat?
Okay, now according to the official handbook, parents may consider allowing children to open just one present on the evening before Christmas. Go for it.
Mommy!
What's wrong, Theo Jr.? Did the guitar scare you? Because it looks like a demonic weapon? Oh, it's okay. I won't let it hurt you. What happened? The blue shirt scared you? Because it's a potential strangulation hazard? Don't be scared. Christmas is nothing to be afraid of.
Give it down there, you fucking Neanderthals! No, no fire department. It's a treasure trove of health and labor violations in that place. Besides, I think the flames are already starting to dwindle.
Theodore, I need a hand down here.
Not now, Marjorie. There's a tiny inconsequential fire at Factory 6.
Sweetheart!
Lord, are you okay?
Don't touch me! You've done enough damage here! Hey, what are you doing in here? Do I ever set foot in your rooms? Get back here!
Theodore, stop it! They were just concerned for their father!
They can't see me in a state of weakness or they'll lose respect for me, Marjorie! I'm kind of an authority figure around here! You people think I could just stop working at the drop of a nut sack? That I'm vulnerable due to my factory exploding, subjecting me to countless criminal investigations?
Literally no one is thinking any of that, Theodore!
What if I'm so weak and vulnerable? How would I be able to do this? I'm stronger than a velociraptor!
We're sorry, sweetie!
You like that little Theo? That's you! This plant is used! What's the other one's name? Steve? This plant represents your stupid little face, Steve!
No! Our government issued trees!